Welcome to Adaxes. In this video, we'll be looking at data standards enforcement. This feature of Adaxes enables you to ensure that all information stored in Active Directory, Exchange, and Office 365 is unified and obeys your organization's standards, which means that all properties that need to be populated are properly populated. Values like phone numbers or IDs are always in the correct format, and so on. In addition to that, Adaxes can simplify the data entry process for users, for example, when they're creating or modifying various objects. So let's go ahead and create a new user in AD with the help of Adaxes web interface and see how it works in real life. As I'm filling in the first name and last name for the new user, note that the full name and logon name fields are generated on the fly. This means I don't need to enter the same thing manually once again, and I could even remove them from the form completely if I wanted to. In Adaxes, this is done with the help of property patterns. So let's switch to the administration console and see how it's configured. This is the property pattern for user accounts, where all their properties are set up. And as you can see, the full name has got a template for its default value, which is set to first name and last name. And that's exactly what we've seen generated back on the user creation form. But if I want to, I can change it to anything that I need. For example, I could change the format of the full name to be last name, uppercase, comma first name, by simply creating another template for the default value. And the same principle works for logon name, which we've also seen on the form, as it has its own template set to first letter of the first name followed by last name or lowercase, which I could also customize if I needed to. In case your organization has more complicated rules for generating logon names or any other fields, and using templates isn't enough for you, Adaxes lets you use PowerShell scripts for that. So you can generate values based on any custom policies, no matter how complex they are. Apart from automatically generating property values, Adaxes also allows certain fields to be set as required. For example, if I try to create the new user right now, Adaxes won't let me do that, as the department field can't be left empty. Also, note that I can't type anything for the department. All I can do is select one of the provided options from a drop-down list, which means that there's no space for making errors. So let's see how we can configure that. If we have a look at the department field, we can see that it's set to be required. That's why Adaxes didn't allow me to leave it empty. And the property is set to take only one of the predefined values, thus the drop-down list. Here I can have any values that I need, like the list of all departments in my organization. And if at some point there's a new one created, I just need to add it to the list and that'll be it. Another thing that Adaxes allows me to do is to require certain fields to accept values only in a specific format. An example of such a field here is employee ID. To let the users know which format they need to use, you can provide a custom hint text in the field itself, and custom help, which shows more detailed instructions when clicked on. However, if all our prompts didn't help and somebody still enters an employee ID in the wrong format, Adaxes has got us covered, as in that case it will show an error message, also customizable, and simply won't accept any values that aren't in the required format. The only way to proceed is by entering a valid employee ID. The way such behavior is configured is by using a regular expression to put constraints on the value of employee ID. Here I can also provide the text that I want to appear in the error message when the entered value doesn't match the regex. And I can provide the text for the hint and the help messages that we've seen back on the form. The latter also supports HTML editing, so I can use all sorts of formatting for it. With Adaxes, property patterns can be applied to any property, including account options, profile settings, phone numbers, passwords, Exchange extension attributes, and others. If you have an extended Active Directory schema, you can apply property patterns to your custom attributes in the same way you do for standard AD properties. Now, let's set up default logon hours to allow users to log on Mondays through Fridays, but not on weekends. To do that, all we need to do is simply add the logon hours property to the property pattern and set the default value that we need. As easy as that. Once it's set up, we can come back to the web interface and finish creating our user. And when the new account is created in AD, which we can now see, note that the logon hours are denied on Saturdays and Sundays, just like we've set them to be. And that was done without me doing anything about it on the user creation form. Similarly, the user's display name and company fields were also filled in, even though I didn't put anything in them, It was all done for me by Adaxes. Adaxes can also handle situations when certain properties need to have unique values. As you can see in the logon name field, there's a number added at the end. This is because the original logon name that was generated appears to be taken by another user, so Adaxes automatically changed it to a unique value. This is just one example of how you can handle non-unique values with Adaxes, and if you have your own policies for that, you can apply them. This functionality can also be very useful when importing new users in bulk from CSV. For example, it allows you to avoid those painful errors that pop up when some of the properties, like UPNs, get values that already exist in AD. Also, if certain columns are missing from the CSV file, Adaxes can either automatically generate values for these properties during the import process, or set default ones for them. Property patterns also work when editing objects. So for example, if at some point you update the last name of the user, properties like full name and display name will also be automatically updated. And even though we were mainly talking about users, property patterns can actually be applied to any AD objects like computers, groups, OUs and others, including your own custom object types. Finally, Adaxes allows you to finely tune where exactly the property patterns will operate. For example, you can enforce the same data standards across all your AD domains. Or, on the contrary, you can have different data standards in different locations by applying different property patterns to them. For example, here we have several offices, and if we're creating a new user in the London office, we'll have one set of departments available to select from, which are associated with this particular office. But if we're creating a new user in the Berlin office, the set of departments will be different, and you can treat any other property in the same way. So, with data standards enforcement provided by Adaxes, you can safely delegate filling in forms and editing data in Active Directory to users without the risk of them breaking something. And at the same time as minimizing the risk of human error, you also make sure that all the data in your environment is standardized and unified. Thanks for watching.